Eternal Father, I offer you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. May the love and mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. I'm Reverend Father Innocent Yangobridge of Kabale Diocese, sharing with you the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ. Today, the 1st of July 2021, and the 7th day of our novena, reciting the chaplet of divine mercy, praying for our country, Uganda, that the merciful God may stop this coronavirus pandemic that is indeed still a big challenge to live with. From the Gospel of today, from Matthew chapter 9, verses 1 to 8, Jesus returns to his own city where they bring to him a paralytic lying on his bed. Seeing the faith of the people who brought the paralytic, Jesus tells the paralytic, "Take heart, my son, your sins are forgiven." Dear friends, Jesus is moved to say those words to the paralytic, not because the sick man or the people who brought him were wonderful people, handsome people, you know, friends of Jesus, or rich men, or perhaps because they were fellow countrymen or his neighbors. Absolutely not. It's because of their faith that Jesus was moved. Therefore, what moves Jesus to act is our faith. Whereas it is a fact that God created us, and as one philosopher puts it, God is the unmoved mover. Yet, there is only one chance given to man by the same God to move God. And dear friends, that is by and through faith. How much faith do I have? I believe, dear friends, that as we face this challenge of coronavirus in Uganda and in the entire world, only men and women of faith will move God to act and stop this coronavirus. But the question still is, do we have faith? In the day of St. Faustina, number 1059, Jesus tells St. Faustina that, "I desire trust from my creatures. Encourage souls to place great trust in my fathomless mercy." Jesus wants our trust. He wants our faith. It is by our faith that we trust. Do we trust God? Dear friends, in the first reading of today, from Genesis chapter 22, verses 1 to 19, we have the example of a man of faith, and that's none other than Abraham. Abraham is told by God to sacrifice his only son as a burnt offering. Abraham does not hesitate. He goes and takes his only begotten son to sacrifice him to God. And while on the way, Isaac, his son, asks the father, "Where is the ram for a burnt offering?" Abraham is quick to answer, "God will provide himself the lamb for a burnt offering." Abraham, a man of faith, trusted against all odds that God himself would provide a lamb. And this is what we exactly see in the four men who present the sick man, the paralytic, to Jesus to heal. They believe that Jesus would provide, and indeed he provided. He healed the paralytic by also, first and foremost, healing his heart of all its sins. Dear friends, when Jesus tells the paralytic, "Your sins are forgiven," I want to believe that he wants to say the same to us. Ugandans, your sins are forgiven. Are we ready, dear friends, to take our sins to Jesus so that we are forgiven? By the way, when did I last confess? When did I last repent my sins? That's a question we need to answer. Dear friends, in the face of coronavirus, we must allow Jesus to heal us of the coronavirus of our sins. I know Many times I talk about coronavirus. It is now becoming like a song. But dear friends, let's not forget that we are also sinners. That there could be a bigger coronavirus than the one we have. The coronavirus of our sins. Jesus is ready to forgive us. Jesus is ready to tell us, my daughter, my son, your sins are forgiven. Please, let us go. He will forgive us. Wherever you are, begin praying and asking God to forgive you your sins. May we therefore pray, friends. Lord Jesus Christ, you who told the paralytic, my son, your sins are forgiven. And when even the Pharisees were rather scandalized by the words you said, you continued your way of forgiving the paralytic his sins, but also healing his physical sickness by telling him, get your stretch and go back home. Jesus, in the face of coronavirus, may you forgive us all our sins, and may you heal us of all our sicknesses so that we are whole again. This is our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May the God of love and mercy bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.